Hello and welcome. My name is John Dickinson, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how I created this look, which is one of the many new presets included in Sapphire 2022.5 using the Sapphire Effect Builder. So, download the project file and let's get started. Okay, so I have the Sapphire logo resolve composition open. And if we come down to the bottom here and solo this seffect_shapesort layer, this is actually an After Effects solid. And in the effect control panel, you can see there's only one single effect applied, and that's seffect. So the seffect effect is creating this entire look. And if we twirl this open, you can see there's a whole range of different effects and different visible parameters. For those of you who are new to Sapphire, seffect gives us access to the Sapphire Effect Builder, in which you can create custom effects and presets. And that's exactly what I've done to create this look, which is also a preset that's included in Sapphire 2022.5. To view all of the new seffect presets included in 2022.5, we can click Load Preset, and with Builder Effects selected, come over to Search Presets and type in 2022.5. And here you can see there's a list of all of the beautiful new backgrounds that were created for seffect in 2022.5. And down the bottom here is shapesort. So I'm going to cancel that for now. And let's focus on this setup. So what we can do is come over and click Edit Effect, which will open up the Effect Builder again. I'm just going to set this to 50%. So Sapphire Builder makes experimentation with Sapphire effects really easy. And if you take a look at this, it might look complicated if you'd never used it before, but I'm telling you, it actually really isn't. So let's walk through this step by step. I'm just going to roll my mouse wheel and make sure Preview Selected Node is selected and click on Source. So with the Source node selected, notice that the preview is black, and that's because the effect was applied to a black solid in After Effects. Now below that on the right, we have Sapphire Shape. I've customized this to 6 points to create the hexagon shape. And notice over here that Sapphire 2022.5 includes widgets in Builder. So this makes the parameters that include widgets much easier to work with because we can access them directly in the preview. Notice also that this shape has a hole cut in the middle. And that hole was created using a duplicate of S shape. And you can see it's a slightly smaller hexagon. And to create the hole, what I've done is I've attached that shape to the mask port of the original shape. And that cuts out the hole. And you can see that for the original shape, invert mask is checked. If we uncheck that, then all we're going to see is the main shape cut out by the smaller one. So these two shapes together create the base shape upon which all of the other effects operate to create this look. And the first one being Bokeh Lights. Now, Bokeh Lights is one of my favorite effects in Sapphire, and I often use it to add these kind of floating particles to my designs. And in this case, notice how the lights are only visible closer to the shape. And that's because Use Source Color is set to 1. If we bring that down all the way to 0. Now we have the bokeh lights covering the entire frame. So this is a really nice way to get your lights to hug the objects that you've applied them to. If we just come up and choose Load Preset. I actually created a preset for this exact thing, which was included in version 2022. And that's this one down here, Source User. So that's the preset I always start with when I want to create this kind of look. Going to cancel that. Notice also that these lights are also a hexagonal shape. And that's because shape is set to 6 sides. And I've also dropped roundness right down to 0. And that gives us nice sharp points. At its default setting, it's a little bit rounded. And I wanted this to be really nice and sharp. Now, next in the stack is Parallax Strips. This is one of my other favorite Sapphire effects. I'm just going to roll my mouse wheel out a little bit. I'm also using the right mouse button just to get the hand grabber tool, just to move the view over. So parallax strips has fractured this hexagon shape into these short horizontal strips. And I've got the mode set to manual. If I just drag that, you can see how they slide across like that. And this is being keyframed in After Effects. We'll take a look at that a little later. To remove the strips from this inside area, I've taken the same shape mat and I've dragged it into the mask port for parallax strips. If I just disconnect that, we can now see those fractured parts on the inside. And I didn't want that, so I just masked them out. And obviously this is one of the powers of Sapphire Builder. Being a node-based editor means I don't have to duplicate effects. I can reuse existing ones. Next in the stack is Sapphire Texture Folded. And Texture Folded is great for all kinds of organic flowing liquid style effects. And here I've used it to add this kind of soft flowing light source that's moving across the object. Up until this effect, everything is pure white, so this is a nice variation in contrast. And this is also going to be enhanced by Ultra Glow, which will pick up these brighter areas. Now, the next four effects, Warp Repeat, Tile Scramble, Pixel Sort, and Parallax Strips, have all been used to further fracture and offset this hero shape. So let's take a look at Warp Repeat first. Notice how Steps has been set to 3. You can bring that right up and you can get a much smoother style. But I wanted this really quite low. Notice also that 2 Rotate has been set to 45, just to rotate those around. And this is nice because it adds a bit of random angle to these shapes. That's followed by Sapphire Tile Scramble. And Tile Scramble gives you this fractured blocky look. After that, we have Sapphire Pixel Sort, which adds these fine horizontal lines. Notice how these are going to extend and contract according to the contrast changes of the image. A nice little bit of auto animation there. And I love how it adds this nice fine detail. And beneath that, we have a duplicate of parallax strips, and that breaks it all up and slides all the pieces horizontally. Once again, I can just drag the manual amount here. You can see how everything's sliding. So as I mentioned, it's so easy to experiment in Sapphire Builder. I was just choosing effect from over here in the effect panel and dragging it in here and just playing with some of the settings and seeing what it looked like. If I wasn't happy with the look, I'd grab another effect and drop it in. And these are the four effects that I decided on. So that's the background, but of course we can't see the hexagonal shape. In order to reintroduce that, I've used Sapphire Layer and connected everything up to Texture Folded, so all of these, directly down into the foreground port of Sapphire Layer. Everything else is piped into the background port. So now we have the foreground shape minus these four effects in the foreground, and we have the background, including these four effects. I use Sapphire Layer all the time in the Effect Builder to create these kind of setups. And notice also that mode for S Layer is set to add. Now, for the color treatment, I've used three effects. The first is Quad Tone, and that's giving me this rich, warm caramel look. You see color one set to this darker orange, and color two is set to this bright yellow. There's also a whole load of presets that you can choose from for Quad Tone. Beneath that is Ultra Glow. And for this, I've increased the threshold quite a lot. I didn't want too much glow. Remember, I talked about Texture Folded and how those brighter areas would appear more obvious when glow was applied. And that's exactly what happens. So as the texture moves, you can see the brighter areas move across the object and they receive the glow based on the threshold. If we just decrease this threshold, we can add more glow. I didn't want too much, just a little bit of bloom in these brighter areas. And to finish this look, I used my favorite Insta Color Grade effect, Color Fuse Looks. And for that, I haven't used LUT 2 or 3, just LUT 1, and you can see the setting that I chose here. Basically for this, I just come in and I just tried different lookup tables until I see something that I like. Okay, so here's the result of those tweaks to that Shape Sort preset. And you can see how combining Sapphire effects in Effect Builder, you can really create some eye-popping results. Now there's one more thing I want to mention in Builder, and that's the parameter display option. I'm just going to come back up to shape and select that. Notice over here in the controls that some of the parameters are checked and some of them aren't. And the check parameters are the ones that I decided would be the most useful to access directly within the After Effects effect control panel. Now, the key thing to know here is that up until version 2022.5, the current limit of effects that can display parameters is 10. So in this setup, I've got more than 10 effects, which means if we come down to something like, let's see, color fuse looks, that some effects will display this little yellow icon. And clicking on any of these parameters has no effect. So I really have to choose wisely which effects that I think are going to be the most useful inside of After Effects to show in the effect control panel. If you go over the limit of 10, what you can do is select one of the effects, not tile scramble. Let's say shape, for example. Come up to the top and click, and then click again to deselect all of the parameters. And if I come back down to the bottom, you can see that's opened up a slot for another effect. So now I can check this one and include all parameters, or just deselect the ones I don't want to see inside of After Effects or inside of the host that you're using. But if an effect can't be included, we can of course come back into Builder by clicking on Edit Effect and have access to all of the parameters. But that's just something to keep in mind. Okay, so I'm just going to cancel that. Back here in After Effects, this little hexagon here is the shape and shape mat. And it's nice and small because I've actually set size keyframes for shape. And if I just drag the time indicator, you can see how that increases in size. Notice also that it starts to fracture as well. I've added a couple of keyframes for parallax strips manual amount. So starting at zero, so we see no fracture, and then as it scales up, it starts to fracture and slide to the left. And notice also on the right-hand side of the frame, later in the comp, it starts to come in from the other side. And that's because I've set wrap in parallax strips to reflect. But you could also use tile if you wanted to. And as for the background, I've set a couple of keyframes again for parallax strips, just so it starts almost empty, and then those strips start to slide on and fill the frame. If I just press the U key with that layer selected, there's keyframes for the shape effect and keyframes for shape mat and the manual amount for both parallax strips effects. And you can see how I've used easing in and easing out just so that we ease out and ease into the keyframes. Now above that, we have the Sapphire logo inside a pre-comp, and there's a couple of keyframes here for scale. So this is just doing a little scale up. And if we come back to the resolve, you can see that scale is matching the scale of the Sapphire shape effect. But it finishes before the Sapphire shape size animation. And notice also that the logo has the bokeh lights effect, and that's using the same use source color parameter set to 1. And because we're using the source color, that's why the bokeh lights are pink. Beneath that, we have Sapphire Ultra Glow, just for a nice soft glow. You'll see there is a bit of vertical glow going on there. That's because I've set Afterglow vertical streaks to 2, about 2.3 here, which is a really nice effect. Above that, we have the Sapphire text and the 2022.5 text. And notice there's masks applied to both of these. And these slide out from behind the mask. Let me just quickly show you how that effect was created. I'm just going to duplicate the Sapphire text and just solo it. Just hit the U key and just remove the keyframes. So I've keyframed mask path and position. So I'll just add those keyframes back in again. Just move ahead in time slightly. Grab the pan behind tool, which is this one here. I've already got mine selected. And watch what happens down here. You'll see a couple of keyframes I created when I click and drag. So it's creating keyframes for mask path and position. So it's animating the position of the text and also the mask. But what happens is it appears that the mask isn't moving. So that way we get this reveal from behind the mask. I love that little technique. So I did that for both the Sapphire text and the 2022.5 text. Let me just solo this text. So you can see that's revealing in the opposite direction, but that text is also parented to the Sapphire text. So the Sapphire text has some position animation keyframes, which we just saw how to set. And because the 2022.5 text is parented to it, it slides along with that as well, which gives a really nice sort of cohesive reveal. Notice also that 2022.5 has bokeh lights applied. And the last effect is ultra glow. Now, this is just basically being applied to the text and the area around the text just by using a mask. I didn't want too much glow on this text. If I bring it all the way across here, I thought that was way too much. The kind of effect I was looking for was that the orange hexagon was sort of generating light and the text was glowing, or the text closer to this shape was glowing, and then we got this sort of fall off where we didn't get any glow here. And once again, here's the final look. Okay, so thanks for watching. I hope you found that useful. Go ahead now and spend some time inside the Effect Builder and see what you can create. Be sure to leave a comment with any thoughts or questions. And if you're new to Sapphire, you can visit borisfx.com where you can learn more and download a demo.